In this video, we're going to talk about things that are going to cripple, and I mean absolutely cripple, your ability to be self-reliant from here on in moving forward. So you got to stick with me, folks. Let's get to it. All right, guys, so I figured I'd try out some new digs today. Try out the hat ordeal. It works for Coleone, so maybe it can work for me. Diamondback truck tonneau covers represent. If you ain't got a Diamondback on your truck, you ain't an American. All right. Now, what I want to say, I just noticed that I kind of look like Ernest P. Worrell. Hey, Merle, where are you at, Merle? I want to start off by saying that the purpose of this channel is to help everybody get prepared for emergencies and disaster situations. We're talking about the big disasters, not just, oh, the lights are out for a day, okay? We're talking about what happens when the crap hits the fan. That's what this channel has always been about. I ain't gonna sugarcoat it, and I ain't gonna pretend we ain't preparing for this whole thing to collapse. That's what we're preparing for, all right? But I think we all got a little taste of that in the last couple of years, and people have warmed up to the fact that, hey, this is a possibility. If we're all hardwired into this technological apparatus, this big giant incubator that keeps us on life support, then what happens when the plug gets pulled? Well, we all seen what happened last year. Now, this channel is geared towards everybody. I don't care what your political affiliation is. I don't care what race you are, what ethnicity, what cultural practices you have. I don't care what your sexual orientation is, what your sex is, what your gender is, whether you're a transgender, transformer, whatever. I don't care if a robot, cyborg, whoever can watch this channel, and I hope that you get something out of it. That's the purpose of this channel, to bring everybody together, to have universal appeal. And that's why I take a moderate stance on most political issues. I'm not provocative in any of the things I say. I try not to incite, whether directly or indirectly, people to do stupid shit. Okay, I always encourage people to use your heads, stay out of mobs, mind your own business, do your thing, but to get prepared. Okay, that's what the purpose of this channel is all about. But I am worried about guilt by association. Unfortunately, I think in light of recent events, that the hammer is going to come down on a lot of people within this genre just because of the associations that they might have with other people within the community. Okay. And I want to make it abundantly clear that YouTube is a wonderful platform. I love this platform. Without this platform, none of us would be here. You cannot deny that it is one of the best products around, and we would be in a very entitled bunch of people for us to just brush that off and, you know, get all upset about it not going our way. Okay, we have to appreciate the fact that this platform has brought a lot of people together and has allowed a lot of people to make a living doing this. Now, I do hope that if a channel is scrutinized to determine whether or not it should be canceled or whatever, the person looking at that is looking for nuance and is looking for the aforementioned things I just talked about, okay? Because there's very few channels out there who are just simply there to provoke, okay? Sure, there's channels which may flaunt their political opinions every once in a while, but I mean, who doesn't? That's what makes YouTube, YouTube. It's about the people, okay? It's about you personally. It's not just generic information all the time. It's about our personalities, our imperfections, our idiosyncrasies, all these things. That's why people watch these videos in the first place. So if you strip it of that entirely, it ceases to be the YouTube, and it ceases to be what initially drew people to the platform in the first place, and eventually is just going to cement itself as another mainstream media outlet with a bunch of prefabricated content. If that's what it becomes, fine. There's that old saying, what is it? You know, don't be successful long enough to become the villain or something like that. I don't know. Is it true? Maybe it is. But regardless, this is a wonderful product, and I love it. But what you need to understand is that big tech is under pressure to dissociate itself from anyone deemed a political liability. And unfortunately, preppers, we find ourselves at a crossroads because we're not just blowing stuff up in our backyard like some channels that get millions of views. And, you know, we're not just a joke channel who's just all about, you know, explosions and entertainment. We're also educational channels. We're also talking about taking practical steps to get yourself more prepared. Now, unfortunately, a lot of people conflate their own political and religious views with that. If they want to do that, in my personal opinion, I think that's fine. Unfortunately, because there's that practical outlet for preparedness, I do believe that preppers may be singled out as a target. And I used to not think this, but then I heard a CBC interview probably a few weeks ago where somebody was conflating prepping with people who are actually prepping for civil conflict. And okay, that's maybe one avenue where some preppers dwell. But myself personally, that's not really what I'm preparing for. I've always said that that's a long shot. I mean, yes, there's going to be pockets of civil unrest here and there that pop up throughout the downfall of civilization as we know it. But that's not the primary thing. There's 101 things to prepare for. That's just one of them. So I truly hope that this preparedness movement, we shouldn't even call it a movement because it isn't a movement, just preparedness in general, doesn't get conflated and wound up in that whole idea of, you know, insurrection and civil war and this and that, because that's not what this channel is about. It's never been about that. Now, if you are a stereotypical channel, like political channel that toes the party line and, you know, like a Candace Owens, a Ben Shapiro, a Kyle Kalinske, a Rational National, a Vaush, you know, Conservative Twins, people like that, you're probably going to be all right because that they're okay if you just kind of keep it at that level. But once you start taking practical steps to prepare yourself, then I think that's where a lot of people get the wrong idea with what we're trying to do. The goal is to achieve self-reliance. It's to be able to take care of yourself if all the systems that we depend on cease to exist, okay? So prepping is about knowing how to defend yourself, okay? It's about knowing how to medically care for yourself if help is not available, with the understanding that if the grid were to go down, you know, hospitals may be overwhelmed. There may not be people who have the ability to give you the type of medical attention you need. And so you need to be able to either administer that yourself. And these things are taboo because a lot of these spaces are regulated. So being able to fix things, okay, and not succumb to the planned adolescence, conspicuous consumption model of materialism, which basically defines the modern era of capitalism that we live in. It means knowing how to grow your food without any sort of regulatory oversight. So this is another area where, you know, government often wants to get involved in regulating. If you're, you know, raising livestock, animal husbandry, you know, even if you're hunting, you know, all these things are heavily regulated. Even water catchment systems in some places is heavily regulated process. So for that reason, we're trying to empower people to just have an awareness of these things, have an understanding of these things, because we understand that society is a frail thing. Technology is not God-given. We've come very far as a species, okay? And the system, in my opinion, has proven to be quite resilient in light of all the things that have gone on. But we still need to know how to generate our own energy, how to procure and manage potable water, and just essentially thinking independently, the ability to use our own discernment to understand what's going on, knowing that there's a lot of special interests out there. And this is not a conspiracy thing. This is just a fact. We should all know by now, and basically the government has demonstrated this in the last year, that they will tell you things which are patently false for the greater good. So our job is knowing what's true and acting on that. Now, that's where the problem kind of comes in, because I'm always one to look at the science on this channel. I'll always lean towards the science. I know that there's such a thing called the academic industrial complex. You know, I used to work in academia. You know, even social psychologists will talk about things like groupthink. These are things, phenomena that actually exist, okay? Consensus, validity, and all of these things. These are real fallacious reasonings that people partake in when perhaps, you know, something is new or they don't have all the information or there's a lot of social, economic, political pressure to do certain things. But I tend to lean towards science, which is why, case in point, I take a lot of flack for this opinion, because a lot of people have been put under the spell to think that this is a political issue. But I'm a firm believer that the climate is going screwy and it's not going to get better. And it's likely going to have cataclysmic effects around the world in the coming years. And these are things that we're just going to have to prepare for. Not a popular idea in this predominantly conservative preparedness movement. Now, again, I'm a moderate, so I welcome all types of voices. You know, I get scared when I see the left get too much power, and I get equally scared when I see the right get too much power. Not many people can wrap their heads around that, because a lot of people are very, very entrenched in their opinions. But one thing we can agree on, if you're watching this channel right now, it doesn't matter if you're left or right, you understand full well that things can go bad and you need to be ready for it. And at the end of the day, we're all just human beings. Okay, one thing I've talked about on this channel before is that if you ever entered a Mad Max world, okay, if we ever went into a Walking Dead type universe, those dichotomies between the left and the right, and even black and white to a very large extent, those things are going to take the back seat to survival. Okay, you're not gonna be running around the post-apocalypse wondering if somebody's a liberal or a conservative. Okay, these are labels that we have the luxury of enjoying right now. And sure, you know, you might start to see societies form around certain principles which can be associated with either of those things, but by and large, people are just gonna be trying to survive. So always keep that in mind. Keep that in mind that if you got $1 billion in the bank, for one, you probably had to bring something of value to a lot of people in order to get it there, okay? Some people will debate that, but I'm a firm believer now that the only way you get insurmountably wealthy, like a lot of people have, is if you're either a really good investor like Warren Buffett, or you've created a product that many people have come to enjoy, that's made their lives easier. Look, as much as I hate Amazon, they bring you good deals at great prices. Unfortunately, they're not the only game in town. My store is one of them. And I wanna interject here and say that I've come under fire recently from numerous big tech organizations. I'm not gonna go into the specifics, but all I'm gonna say is that the best way to support this channel is to go to my store, canadianpreparedness.com, where I only sell high quality products. I turn a lot of products down because they're, quite frankly, I don't want to say garbage, but they're just not a good value for people, okay? Or they're just, they're not going to stand up to the abuse. And yeah, they're probably going to be a little bit more pricey. And unfortunately, I've put a target on myself in doing that, because I can tell you right now that there are things that they don't want me to sell. There are things out there that when we do finally go cashless, you are not going to be able to buy, except if you go into a store and pay by God knows how you're going to pay. Maybe you're going to have to pay with gold. Maybe you're going to have to barter somehow, or you're going to have to hope that there's some sort of crypto which is going to facilitate that. Speaking of which, we are going to be accepting crypto. We currently accept Coinbase-based crypto. So if you're on Coinbase, if you know what that is, you can buy stuff through CanadianPreparedness.com. So that's a great way to support the channel. And I'm telling you guys, it's no BS. It's the best survival and preparedness gear that you can find. And it's a lot of novel stuff that you're not going to find anywhere else, and you get it all in one place. Stuff that you're not even going to find off Amazon. We have very competitive shipping rates, so go check it out. Anyways, that's a way you can support me, because the deplatforming has already begun. Now, I'm not going to tell you to go to another platform. You know, I'm going to continue to do what I do here, because I don't believe that I have anything to be afraid of, because I don't think anything I'm saying right now is too off the rails. In fact, I think it's quite the opposite. I think I'm providing a very good explanation of what my motives are. And even people within my preparedness clique, like the other channels that I promote on my homepage and stuff like that, all of those channels, I think, rep the cause of preparedness very well. And they do it in a way which is not gonna alienate people who are just getting into this. But the problem is, I wanna do videos about firearms. I want to do videos about hunting, about processing wild game, about more sensitive topics, but I'm scared to do that. I'm genuinely scared to do it, even though I know that YouTube has improved in their algorithms sorting of that type of content as of late. It is starting to get better. So I'm hoping that YouTube is ahead of the curve with a lot of its creators. And again, I can't say enough good things about this platform. I mean, we're all on it for probably the better part of the day. I mean, it's the new TV. YouTube is the second largest search engine, if not the first largest search engine on the internet next to Google. So, I mean, it is what it is. It's great. And I don't think that this is necessarily some conspiracy to turn this into mindless consumer drones with no autonomy. Well, maybe it might be. But I think it's mostly economic forces, political forces, and a confluence of those things that are pressuring everybody to keep us on this inflationary debt-based dependency. And what I mean by that is that the market right now is structured so that you need debt to survive. They need you to be in debt. We don't live in a deflationary economy. There's this idea called technological deflation. And what it is, and I'm not trying to be pretentious or anything, what it is, I just read a book, The Price of Tomorrow, and it was an excellent book. And anyways, what technological deflation is this. The idea is that as technology improves, things should be getting cheaper. When you think about it, you know, I mean, if you have robotic tractors harvesting the crops and planting the seeds and doing all the work, stuff should be getting cheaper, but it isn't. The cost is actually inflating. And the only reason why it's inflating, because we live in this debt-based economy. So the economic conditions that we're living in are archaic and are not compatible with the technological future of abundance, which is possible. We're on the cusp of, you know, 3D printing, nanotechnology, robotics, autonomous vehicles, all of these things, gene editing, that could potentially create an era of Star Trek-like abundance. But it's not going to happen without a squeeze. And it's probably not going to happen without a war. And it's probably not going to happen without climate disaster. There's a lot of things that are going to have to happen. And I just call that the squeeze. I call that going through the birth canal. The only way that this whole crypto thing is realized and the whole blockchain revolution is realized, where everything is decentralized and everybody's free to say and do whatever they please without fear of being deplatformed, and let the marketplace of ideas just sort it out and let the truth prevail, let good prevail, let virtue prevail in the natural way that it should. The only way that's going to happen is if there's a squeeze, and the squeeze is a coming. You can bet your ass that the squeeze is coming, because we're going to see inflation like you've never seen it before in the next few years. And that is going to pump the stock markets up. People are going to be like, oh, the stock market's going up. And, you know, look, we're up 10, 15% a year, you know, compared to 5% in a normal year, whatever, right? But it's not going to be what it is, because the dollar is going to be down 15% a year. So it's going to be an illusion. But people are going to believe it until they look at the cost of property, until they look at the cost of groceries in the grocery store and the cost of a vehicle and all of these things, okay? The costs are starting to go up. And I'm going to be brutally honest, I've had to raise my prices at CanadianPreparedness.com because the damn dollar keeps dropping, okay? It's sinking like a stone. And you need to be aware of this, that prices are going to go up. And they're not really going up, it's just that the dollar is getting really devalued. So that's something to keep in mind. So look, here's what I'm trying to say. I think that if we were to play this tape through to the end, whether it's a conspiracy or not, I just think that the end result of all this is, you know, we're going to be sitting in our tiny homes, in our little cubicles, on our virtual reality machines, you know, getting served hand and foot by these Amazon drones that come to our house, and, you know, everything's going to be social distancing. You're not going to be able to interact with anybody anymore, except if you're 6 feet away. And even dating is probably going to go into that Demolition Man thought sex thing, where, you know, sex is taboo in the future because swapping of bodily fluids is going to be frowned upon for many reasons, biological mostly, right? You know, because it's going to be too many germs, right? The only people who are going to have firearms are going to be the police. And I'm sure some people haven't really thought that through yet. You really think that's a good idea? A future in which the only firearms you're allowed to have are virtual ones in video games? But the guys in the uniforms, no offense to them, because they're just doing their job, getting paid like everybody else. But, you know, they're just following orders. And we all know what happens when people just follow orders, right? Maybe I should stop shooting myself in the foot right now. What do you guys think? What are you thinking of this hat look? You know, is it Ernest P. Worrell, or is it Colio Noir? What do you think? Or is it CP, Canadian Prepper, Diamondback, represent? Go check those out. Like I say, if you don't have a tonneau cover on the back of your truck that says Diamondback on it, You just ain't no American, you son of a bitch. Anyways, guys, I hope you got something out of this video today. And I hope it was constructive, because my purpose of making these videos is not to get everybody all riled up and, you know, going and searching the internet. No, I want you to get out there. I want you to work. I want you to work harder. I want you to work longer. I want you to get ahead in life. I want you to be more physically fit. I want you to be more emotionally stable. I want you to be more philosophically and morally well-rounded, upstanding citizens. That's my goal. It's not just about surviving and holding out and turtling in and getting by while the getting is good. No, you gotta thrive while the getting's good, so that when the shit finally does hit the fan, and oh boy, I do think it's going to, then you're gonna be as ready as you possibly can be. And not only that, it's gonna teach you a lot. It's just gonna teach you a lot about discipline, delayed gratification, okay? The importance of enduring hardship. Anyways, guys, that's all I gotta say today. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Please support the channel by going to CanadianPreparedness.com, not just for me, but for you, because I want you to get connected with good gear. Unfortunately, we no longer accept PayPal. I'm not going to get into the reasons why, but maybe you can make some inferences on the basis of what I just talked about. They probably don't care about you getting prepared and only want to sell you video games, makeup, and whatever, unicorns and rainbows, okay, and plastic garbage from the wonderful land of you-know-where. They don't want you to get prepared. That's all I'm gonna say about that. But we still accept all major credit cards, and we accept crypto via the Coinbase platform. And we're probably gonna look into, I think it's called BitPay, but let me know if there's any other avenues. You know, we do accept Apple Pay, Google Pay, things like that. Anyways, guys, stay safe, stay ready, and get prepared, because the clock is ticking. Canadian Prepper out.